Hey everyone, and welcome to the video I'm going to be doing on the Restoration Druid RBG guide. So I'll be going through the talents now, and then I'll also be doing a gameplay where I'll go into an RPG and show off the build. So first off, the talents. Cenarian Ward is what I always take due to the fact that it's just so much more easier to use than Abundance. Mostly in RBGs, what you're going to be casting the most is just heals over time, and with Abundance it wants you to use, you know, Healing Touch. So I take Cenarian Ward just so it's an extra hot on a target who's going to be hit. So usually you put Cenarian Ward either on yourself or a high value target like another healer or a Shadow Priest who you know the enemy are going to focus. Next one is down to you. I usually take Wild Charge due to the fact that when you go into Travel Form you can quickly use the Leap and get away from people who are trying to attack you. Next affinity you want to take is Guardian. You always want to take Guardian due to the fact that you're going to be taking a lot of damage if people focus you. So you just want to easily, if they're focusing you, pop Bark Skin, go into your defensive and just spam your Frenzied Regeneration. Because if you double your Frenzied Regeneration, you're going to be doing so much self-healing and you just literally won't be killed. And especially because the targets are going to attack you, Fury's going to be high, so you can easily use Frenzy Regeneration. And if you're getting hit really hard, you can even use Iron Fur, which just makes you indestructible. You also just want to use Mighty Bash, so that if a melee's on the top of you and he's trying to rape you, you can just quickly stun him and get away, either with a Wild Charge or a Displacer Beast. And just get away from it and allow yourself some more pressure. Next, what you want to take is Tree of Life. A lot of people run Coalbation, but I just don't think it's very viable just to find that. Tree of Life comes off cooldown at the same time as your Trank, so at the start of the fight, if your teammate is starting to get low, you can literally just pop an Incarn and then a Trank, and everyone is getting healed for so much. And more than likely, when you pop Tree and Trank, you're not going to have a lot of your teammates dying, so it allows your other healers more breathing room, it just allows a lot more. As well, if you want to be saving mana, you can pop Innovate before you do this, so that once you come out, you're casting for Trank for free mana, and then once you come out, you can just spam regrowths and stuff like that for just free mana. Next, you want to take Germination, so that you can double rejuve. This is really, really good due to the fact that before you start in a fight, if you know that the other team has a lot of melees, you know, a lot of warriors, and they're going to focus one of your healers or one of your high value targets like an SP, you can literally just double rejuve all the targets you know will more than likely be focused. So say your healers, just double rejuve all of them, double rejuve your tank if he's a flag carrier, stuff like that, just so that you know they're going to be taking damage, and with the double rejuves, they're just going to be getting healed for so much. Last talent, a lot of people take Stonebark, like in Freeze, so that when you Ironbark a target, you know they'll be healed. But I take Flourish due to the fact that tied in with Germination, so where if you double rejuve all of the healers and the high value targets, you can literally just use Flourish and they're all extended for even more seconds. And Stonebark, you only get real value out of it, you know, when you're using it, only one person gets value out of it, whereas Flourish, a lot of people are getting the value and your HPS is going to go up, because obviously your rejuves and stuff are going to last longer, and in the long term just helps you have more mana. In PvP I always take Medallion, no matter what. It's just down to personal preference, really, what you like. Some people take Relentless, some people take Medallion, it's down to you. In the second PvP row, I always take Defender of the Weak due to the fact that Vim, you don't really get a lot of use out of it, especially now where most comps have a Shadow Priest or an Amphlee lock, and you're never going to be above 80% more most of the time. So, yeah, you just want to take Defender of the Weak so that if someone does get low and that procs, it's going to help. If that procs, all your hots are going to, you know, tick quicker and just increase healing. Next, you want to take Druid of the Claw just for the fact that if you're getting focused, you can quickly just go into bear form and you get the full use out of Druid of the Claw. Next, what you want to take is Cyclone, especially on maps like Arathi Basin, where you're going to be in small groups going for bases, so like a group of three. Clone is really, really good in small fights. So say if you're getting focused by a rogue or a melee, you can quickly just turn on him, bash, and then clone him, and he's completely out of the fight for about 8 seconds if you time it well. And it just gives you and everyone else a bit of breathing room. Next, what you want to take is Revitalize. I take Revitalize most of the time due to the fact that most comps in RPGs have at least one melee, so you're always going to get the full use out of Revitalize. And Nourish is a bit meh, just because there's so many targets you've got to heal. And obviously you want to take Focus Growth, just the fact that it's so good for keeping your mana, and you can just life bloom the target. And honestly, there's no point for Wild Growth and Overgrowth, because, you know, you've got Tree, where Wild Growth is just going to be healing so much and your regrowths are instant. So yeah, that's where you take Focus Growth. And now I'll quickly show a RPG gameplay of me in it, and then it was a Temple of Harmogu. And that's it, me talking, and we'll go into the gameplay. And make sure you like and comment if you want any more guides, and see you in the next one. So in this PG, I'll just be showing how to heal with the Resto spec I've chosen. So the way this spec kind of works is kind of in the sense how PvE Resto Druids work, and that will be using Germination to try and double rejuve all the targets at the start of a fight. So at the start of this fight, before we engage, I'm just going to double rejuve. I'm just going to double rejuve the Orb Carriers, because obviously they're going to be high priority targets. I'm just going to Life Bloom, and he's going on me, so I'm just going to Bark Skin, and just make sure everyone's hotted. I'm going to Focus Heal and give Iron Bark to the Orb Carrier. I'm also just going to use Tree and... heal the Monk up, use Scenario 1 on the Monk. And I'm just going to Dispel. So now the Rogue's on me. I'm going to double rejuve myself. Move down into the middle. And rejuve the Warrior. Also just going to use my Flourish now and Innovate on myself. You just want to make sure you're always using Innovate. Just so that you can get free heals off. I'm going to go out now and pick up the Purple. I'm just going to stun this Rogue. Couldn't get out. Look at this. I'm going to Scenario Ward myself and put Vortex down so he gets teleported away. And just double rejuve the tank. Put Life Bloom on him so I'm getting faster. And double rejuve as many people as possible. I'm going to Bark Skin myself just so that he gets off me. Just Bark Skin myself. And double rejuve as many people as possible. So I'm just going to fall back now, because it seems a lot of our boys have died. I'm going to use Essence of Ganir here now, because I've got a lot of people rejuved. Just going to make sure everyone's got a hot on them. I'm going to move forward so this guy gets... And now we've got a lot of people hotted and used Flourish, so they're all extended. And now just put Scenario Ward, make sure we get a lot of heals on. Just stun this healer. Everyone's hotted. Just make sure everyone's double hotted. Put down a Iron Bark on the Orb, because you know he's going to get focused. Just going to Swift Mend him, because I know he's going to get hit hard. Just Scenario Ward the closest ally, and I'm just going to get ready to leave the center, because we don't have a lot of people alive. Scenario Ward and double hop. And just make sure they stay alive. I'm gonna get ready to try and disengage and drink. Let's go get, okay, we got the orb. So I'm just gonna heal all the guys in the center. I'm gonna go get this orb. Okay, can't get it. This guy hopefully can stay down in the middle. I'm just gonna stun this warrior now. Stun him now, and that guy can get down to the middle. Just gonna swift win the target. Make sure everyone's double rejuved. Scenario Ward on the target, because I know he's going to get hit, so that it's going to proc. Just going to get ready to try and drink now. I'm going to try and disengage. Just going to drink it so I can just easily get a drink off in the center here. I should be healing him, but just focus healing now. Okay, green dropped. I'm just going to try and get another drink off again. Because if I can get a drink off, I can stay in the center longer and get double rejuves off. So hopefully after I've drunk, I'm going to just double rejuve as many targets as possible in the middle. Especially the high priority targets like the people with the orbs. So you just want to make sure you're always double rejuving high targets. So what I usually do is double rejuve healers first, then high priority targets. Especially in this BG, it's going to be orb carriers. Life Bloom on a target you know is going to get hit, and just give heals out. I'm just going to use Flourish now and Essence of Ganir, just so I know that they're going to stay alive. I'm going to use Swift Bend on that and Iron Bark him, because I know he's going to take a lot of damage. Just hit everyone, so they're going to be going on me. I'm going to get ready soon to pop Tree and Trank, which is a really good, I'm going to Tree and Trank now, just so I know everyone's going to get healed from it. And we have a lot of people in the center who are just guaranteed to live from it. I'm just going to focus heal the Orb Carrier now. When I'm in tree, what I usually do is just spam regrowths, because they're going to be instant and they're going to be healing for so, so much. And like literally no one's going to die when they get an instant regrowth. So hopefully this guy gets down back into the center. I'm going to stun this healer. Oh, he's already dead. Stun this rogue. Focus heal Bobcat. Swift Mend. And just double rejuve as many people as possible. Coming down into the center. Literally what all it is about Mavericks Druids is just double rejuvenate everyone and open your team as the rest. Just going to flourish now, just so that everyone who I've got hots on is getting extended. And just regrowth the target. I'm going to get ready to try and drink now. Get over here. Focus heal Bobcat. Give him Swift Mend. Regrowth. It's double rejuved. Just going to use Innovate here and just double rejuve as many people as possible. Just double rejuves. Try and get to the targets who are not in my line of sight. Stun. I'm just going to use Barkskin here if he focuses me. Double rejuve anyone with everyone. Now I'm just going to try and go to the back and drink. Just quickly get a drink, as much mana as possible. Say I'm sapped, so he might go on me. Alright, just keep going. Just double rejuve as many people as possible. Just going to flourish here so they're extended. And stun this healer. Well, stunned. Just going to get quickly ready to stun this healer. Just going to go bear form. Okay, he's focusing me. I'm going to put down Ursoc's Vortex, stun this healer here. This guy should die. And I'm going to get ready to tree and Trank as soon as they're both up. You see as they line, as you can see, they line up pretty nicely. Just make sure everyone's double hotted. Stun this Monkeela. Just try and drink once we're out of combat. Just try and get as much mana as possible. And double rejuve. Swift Mend. Oh shit, you can do that with the orb. That's pretty fucking insane. Just gonna double hot myself now as well. Give him a few hots, but obviously because he's got the orb for so long, it's unhealable. Just hot everyone up. As you can see, they're just getting cleaned up. Just quickly hot everyone. Double rejuve. Just use Tree and Trank here for a bit of extra healing. Double rejuve you. Give you a regrowth. Life bloom as well. Just make sure they stay alive. Use a wild growth when it's up. Should be open. But yeah, that's it for the resto. Showed why that the tree and why taking tree is just better than cultivation, because it lines up nicely with your trank. But yeah.